your land. How are you feeling right now?
We are just exhausted. We're tired. I mean, this has been a very long journey, and we're trying to keep our hopes up and keep our spirit up. You know, we had some people who put banners up that said, you know, stay strong, God is with us, you know, and we've had some get-togethers to try and, you know, boost some morale. But we're doing what we can to survive.
And I know you're going to be arriving, I mean, we're not sure exactly when, within the next couple of hours. What are you hearing from the crew about when you're going to arrive and the process to get off?
Well, the communication to us seems to be a little slower than it is to the family. They told us between 8 and 10 p.m., but I just heard you say it's between 10 and midnight. So, I don't know. I mean, we're always finding out a day late, you know? It's poor communication.
Have you been frustrated with the crew on board, or is this just more a communications frustration that you have with Carnival?
You know, our steward has been absolutely amazing. The crew here worked, you know, time and a half, endlessly. They were awesome. You know, they're not going to get paid enough, whatever it is. They did the dirtiest work that they could. Shoveling, working into the night, you know, doing things I wouldn't do. So it's not with the crew. They've been awesome.
That's wonderful to hear. And Joe, I know you and Dee haven't had a lot of chance to talk, but obviously you can talk to her now, and it's Valentine's Day. I know you've got to be incredibly, incredibly eager to see her soon.
Yes, I am. I just can't wait to see her. Happy Valentine's Day, honey. I know
Hi, everybody.
It's sad,
I miss you.
I miss you, hon. I love you so much.
I'm making my way back to you.
Well, here I am. I can't wait to see you. It's going to be so wonderful. I can't wait to hold you and kiss you and tell you how much I love you and how much I was worried about you.
I have a sign here that says I love you. I don't know if they caught that, but I'll save it. Keep the shower warm. I need a warm shower.
You can take as many showers as you like.
All right, honey.
Dee, can you tell us a little bit about how tough conditions have been? I know we've heard some horrific stories. Some people have said it isn't as bad as that. Others have talked about raw sewage
some
really horrible images. What have you experienced?
Because I stood in line 3.5 hours to get a burger. Every line for every meal is at least an hour, hour and a half. Every line. In fact, we're missing dinner right now because we didn't get in line. But we had to use the bathroom in hazard bags and put them in the hallway. We had to hand scoop, you know, some of the other bathroom items just to take a shower. It accumulated in the shower. We're doing all this in the dark. You know, there's no hot water. You know, there was water building everywhere. The boat has lifted at least 6 to 18% for days. So water has drifted from one side to the other. So we have to walk on cardboard boxes. The smell has accumulated. It's making us sick. I mean, it's horrid. And, you know, I know for image they need to look good, so we got a better breakfast today. But, you know, we've had, you know, just the same food for days. And so I just can't wait to get off of here. It's just horrible.